From smartphones to cars to your home, electricity is all around us and it fuels our modern society. But one of the ways we overlook electricity is the role that it plays in the petrochemical facilities along the Gulf Coast. Today, we're going to go inside Lee College's classrooms to learn more about the electrical technology program. We're going to find out who enrolls in the program, what they learn, where they work, and how they are contributing to life along the Gulf Coast. Our first stop along the way was to track down Jim Richardson, the Division Chair for Technical Studies and an electrical technology teacher at Lee College. Through Jim, we were able to find out why electrical technology is so important, particularly to petrochemical plants in Houston.
This is what they would typically see from day to day working in a plant.
So when you're talking about, you know, the motor control, this is the motor that is controlling. Is it a specific part of the plant? Is it the entire plant operation?
It's usually one system. In other words, you can take a motor that's attached to a pump and actually pump a product into a tank.
Okay.
And then another motor would actually take the product outside the tank.
It's motors like these that keep plants running. But it's students like these and electricity that will keep the motors running.
You know, if there's problems with motor control circuits, something won't run, then they'll get a work order and they'll go out and this is what they actually work on. So it's important that they understand troubleshooting principles that they can go into and repair the problem quickly and get things back up and running.
So how important are these jobs to the petrochemical industry?
You're looking at starting salary out there of probably anywhere between $52,000 to $60,000 a year.
Wow, I am so in the wrong field.
According to Jim, Lee College offers credentials ranging from a one-year certificate to a two-year associate degree. Those enrolled in the program will take courses ranging from technical math to business report writing, as well as electrical code, wiring, and safety. When they're done, students like Jesus Torres are able to transition to jobs in the field.
So Lee College seemed to be a perfect fit for me.
Jesus graduated with an associate degree from Lee College, became a teaching assistant, then got a job at ExxonMobil, where he has been working as an electrician for the last 5 years.
This is where my first exposure really began to everything that I'm doing now. Kind of liked it, and I got the job that I'm in now, and I just stuck with it. And I love it. You know, I wouldn't change it for anything.
There are risks along with the rewards as well. Jesus was quick to remind us that in this high-pressure job, safety is paramount.
But it's really up to you to decide whether or not you have what it takes to go there and safe and come out of there safe and not get hurt and not get nobody else hurt in the process. Mm-hmm. It's a very dangerous field out there and we need to take care of ourselves and take care of our partners.
Jesus clearly has the stuff to be successful in the field, but says that hands-on learning is the best preparation. I decided to see if he was right. There was just one little problem.
Unfortunately, we do a lot of math.
Because I don't think I even really remember pre-algebra.
Like I just said, I'm not very good at math or science.
I mean, there's a lot of stuff you have to remember.
Well, yeah, there is quite a bit.
Undaunted by this, electrical technology instructor Ray Saldivar agreed to show me a thing or two.
We're going to run a stop-start circuit, so we're going to operate this motor, stop it and start it. And my assistant here is going to do the wiring of it.
So like you were saying, if they've got a new unit coming in, this could be what part of their day involves is completely wiring
it.
I mean, if you're spending your entire day wiring, you have to have kind of a meticulous attention to detail because I'm assuming that it could be easy to just kind of get in a groove and overlook something. While Ray showed us the ropes and quite a few wires, he also told us about the incentives of pursuing this career. The perks tend to come in paychecks. With a steady overtime work available, that $50,000 to $60,000 starting salary can quickly become a hefty chunk of change. I could have, you know, come here, come into this program, really, really worked hard, started out, you know, 50 to 62 base, worked hard, worked my overtime, and 22, 23, be making 80, 90,000.
Well, I've had a couple of high school students that are not even, maybe 20, and they're already full-time employees. For a plant making $100,000 a year, not even 2021, because they got an early start.
As Ray wrapped up our lesson, I felt like I had learned a lot about a high-demand, high-paying job, but there was still one thing I had to do. All right, I don't know any equations, but can I push the button?
Sure you can. And the motor's now running.
That's really exciting.
And there you go. You started to stop your first motor.
Well, that wraps it up for this segment. I'm Annika Rogers. If you want to learn more about this or any other program we offer at Lee College, be sure to visit our website at www.lee.edu and tune into our YouTube channel for more segments.